Hi, I'm Mel, and in this video I'm going to teach you how to edit the bricks that you may have on your website. Bricks are these kind of little quick links that take you to maybe internal or external pages on your site. Normally we have them on the homepage, but you may have them elsewhere as well. We're actually going to edit these bricks down here to match these ones up here. Now bricks are something that only we can add, you can't on your own I'm afraid, but we can certainly edit them. So first off, let's start with this finances brick. If we look at it, it has a background image, as you can see. It also has the title, and if you click on it, it leads to the finances page on our website that you see here. So if we go back to our homepage, and in this one here, we're going to click the little cog underneath its name, like so. Background image, yes, we do want a background image, like we saw a minute ago. Background graphic. Now, we've actually added some for you, as you can see here. I'm going to do another video explaining how you can add your own background images to bricks. But for now, we're going to click on the one that says Council Documents, because that was the little pitch that we had. A link, yes, we would like it to link to somewhere. Now, this first one, you'll find a drop-down list of all the pages on your website in alphabetical order. So we're going to click Finance, that's the one that we want. In brick heading, we want to write finance, like so, and there you go, I actually clicked enter, I didn't mean to. Here we go, we then click save changes, and there you can see our brick that links to our finances page. Perfect. Now this next page says councils. If we click on it, it actually leads to an external site, a picture of Broadstairs in St. Peter's, which also has beautiful homepage bricks that are a little bit different to the ones that we have. As you see, they change in design depending on your website. So what we're going to do for this one is, again, we're going to click on the little cog underneath the brick we want to edit. Yes, we do want a background image. We want one of the councillors. We do want it to link to somewhere. Now, we don't want it to link here. Instead, we're going to choose other. Where we want it to link to is, if I go back to that Broadstairs website, we're going to take the URL from here, highlight it, right click, copy, go back here, and in the other bar we're going to paste it, like so. In heading we want to write councils, and then we want to save our changes. And there we go, we've replicated the brick and it links right back to this page. Perfect. Now for this next one, you'll see that it does link to our agendas and minutes page, so it's an internal link that we want to make. It does have a background image, but it also has this little bit of text underneath right here, so we're going to learn how to do that. If we go underneath here, you click on that, yes, we want a background image, we want the one of meetings, I think. Yes, we're linking it somewhere, we link it to our agendas and minutes. In our heading, we're going to write agendas and minutes, and then in this box here, this is the one that we're going to do now, the text box. So here we want to write please click me, or whatever it is that you would like it to say. Click save changes, and there we go, we've managed to replicate the first brick. Click on that, it does take us to our full council page. Now this last one, I wanted to show you what it would look like if you had no background image, just the text. Unfortunately, I can't show you just the text with a link, because as you can see, our link color is white, so whenever I did that, the text disappeared completely. But we're going to imagine that this links to somewhere, and I'll just explain to you how to add this title and the text underneath. It should be pretty self-explanatory, but we'll go through it anyway. If we click on the cog here, no, we don't want a background image. You may want it to link somewhere, but like I said, because of the text color that we've chosen, you won't be able to see it. So for the minute, we're going to say no. However, we are going to write contact us. Now, it may be that you want to write some contact details, so I could write in the name of our website, maybe the email address to get us at, and our Facebook as well. And then click save changes, and there you have it, I've replicated the one above. Now normally you'd probably want to say yes to this link, and you might want to link it to the contact us page, or it may be that you want to link it to an external site, maybe the website or the Facebook instead. Whichever one, make sure that you put it in here and always save your changes. So there we go, that's how you edit your bricks. Now please bear in mind that all of your bricks will look like this. Some of them might have kind of whooshy graphics, and these ones are called rollover bricks, and they'll just have a little rollover function on them. You may also just have three bricks on a page. And the difference between three bricks and four bricks is it will affect what size of background image you need to put in. So three bricks will just have three, and they'll be a little bit bigger. And these are four bricks, as you can see. I hope you learned a lot about editing the bricks on your website, and I'll see you in the next one.